Mouth-watering fruit pizza. So let's watch and see how I put this all together. First, I have all my fruit. I'm using strawberries, blueberries, some kiwi, and pineapple. And you have your ready-made cookie dough. And of course, this is also going to be topped with a little chocolate syrup, which is optional. So first, we want to make sure that we wash all of our fruit because we want to make sure they are good and clean. And then we go ahead and slice it. I also have some kiwi and pineapple on the side. I also chose to use some walnuts, which is also optional. I used about a half a cup and I chopped them up as fine as I can get them for that extra crunch. Then we use our ready-made cookie dough. You can get this at any grocery store. But first, I started out with just a half portion because I wanted to make sure that it was going to be the right size. And you can mash this into a nice circle or square, however you want your pizza. And I went ahead and added a little bit more because I wanted my pizza to be a little bit bigger. And I went ahead and pulled out my rolling pin to finish rolling it out and smoothing it. I'm using my little on top of the counter dash cooking device, which my mother bought me. And I can use this perfectly for doing my cookie. So I'm going to let this bake for about a good 3 to 4 minutes. And as that bake, I'm going to go ahead and use my cream cheese and get that all situated for my frosting. I'm using about a half a teaspoon of almond extract, or a quarter of a teaspoon, I'm sorry, of almond extract. And then I'm going to go ahead and use a quarter of a teaspoon of vanilla. And this is going to all mix together with our cream cheese and our sugar. And this is going to give it so much good flavor. And you want to put this all together and mix this up really well. And you want to sit it to the side until your cookie is completely cooled. So, as you can see, my cookie is pretty toasty and brown. And you can bake this according to how you want it. I used the rest of the cookie dough and placed it in the oven because I was going to have my son help me decorate this one. So this one came out a nice light golden brown. And then I went ahead after the cookies were completely cooled for about a good 30 minutes. I let him go ahead and decorate his cookie, which he really seemed to enjoy. And I went ahead and decorated the other cookie. And I added my strawberries. He went ahead and he added his other little fruits. And he just really liked doing this project. And like I said, kids will love doing this. And I went ahead and finished it well with my little chocolate sauce. And this was a very delicious dessert. Not very hard and not very fussy. And like I said, it is perfect for the Labor Day weekend that's coming up soon. And as you can see, he really enjoyed it. Okay, so after you've seen my slideshow on how my son and I have done our little fruit pizzas, now it's time to taste it. My boys seem to love it a lot, so I gotta be the judge, at least the final one. So here's mine, and I'm about to take a bite. Very good taste. The fruit is delicious. The cream cheese, the little crunch from the cooking, and I'm kind of glad that I let mine cookie get a little bit darker because it gave it a chance to be able to hold the whipped cream and the cream cheese, and it didn't make it taste soggy. It still have a nice little crunch to it. So depending on how you like your cookie and how you want it to have that final taste, it depends on, you know, whether or not you want your cookie to be dark or you want it to be lighter. With mine being a little darker, it holds up pretty good. It's quite tasty. So please try this recipe. Click like, share this recipe and this video with your friends. And I hope you all have a great day. Thank you and God bless.